It's remarkable to see that over the span of, what, 13 years, you, 12 and a half, 13 years, you build up to the point of $25 million a year.
$7 million on lawyers.
$7 million on lawyers. On average every year? Or
that's in why everyone
last
loves
year,
them.
It was in the last few years, four and a half, five, seven, $7 million. We file public tax returns. This is all public information.
Yep.
990 tax return. $7 million. I had lawyers making over $1 million a year, which is double my salary. You can look that up.
Apparently, some lawyers are still making some money off of Project Veritas.
And I got to raise money to defend myself here. With the process is the punishment. How are you gonna raise $500,000? People say, how do you do that? If you go to my Telegram page, there's a link. There's a C4 that we have. I'm not on the board. I'll tweet it. You can donate. But Tim, I could write 30 war stories. I was in court last September in D.C., federal court, civil trial. They sued me for breach of fiduciary duty, trespass, and some other things. Jury trial.
Who
Democracy Partners.
Right,
Bob
Creamer. Right.
It was the video inciting violence.
Yeah.
I was in a sensory deprivation chamber, a.k.a. a federal courtroom, for like a week and a half in Washington, D.C., which is its own hellhole, because when you're in D.C. for 24 hours, it's like a spiritual attack against you.
Yeah.
And there's a jury, and there's all these lawyers, and I'm on the witness stand, and I could have probably settled the lawsuit, I don't know, for something, a couple hundred grand, maybe $100,000. But I chose to do what I thought was the right thing and not settle it and go to the Supreme Court if I had to. Millions.
Yep.
Over $1 million spent. It was the right thing to do. But to do that, you have to walk through walls. You have to do things that people don't want to do. Like Michael Jordan said, you know, leadership has a price.
Yeah.
And victory has a price. And are we willing to pay it?
You know why news like what you do is so fleeting? I mean, I think you do, but for the audience, the rhetorical you. I've told the story before because I've encountered this literally talking to heads of media. You get a guy who comes into, you get a journalist or a media guy, and he goes to the investors and says, I want to do this investigative reporting and expose corporate and governmental malfeasance. I need investment capital to get started. And the venture capitalists and the business guys go, awesome, fantastic. This sounds really, really good. So what's our return? And you say, well, you know, this kind of news does really, really well. Millions of views, 10 million views, 20 million views. It's amazing. And we can sign up people to be members, support our work. So, you know, we could be looking at a very lucrative enterprise and say, yeah, but timeline wise, when are you going to get the story? When's the first big scoop?
Right.
And you say, well, I don't know. We have to do the investigation. And they say, how much does that cost? That's going to cost $300,000 for the preliminary investigation. And they say, and how much do I get back from that? Well, we don't know. We're investigating a story. We have no guarantee the story pans out the way we think it's going to.
That's right.
And they say, I am not going to invest millions of dollars or even $300,000 unless you tell me when I get my money back. Then someone else walks in the room and says, don't listen to that guy. I'm going to launch a news company and I'm going to get you a $2 million return in 3 years. And they go, oh, wow, how are you going to do it? We're going to publish clickbait garbage nonsense and complain about people's politics. Yep,
because
and
it's
they go,
cheap.
Bang.
Because you work for Vice, right?
That's right.
Shane Smith.
Yep.
It's funny. Shane Smith, my executive assistant's name is Shane Smith with a Y, not an N-E. And Vice's unique value proposition was, we go there. I think I saw a billboard in New York Times, Times Square, we go there.
Yeah, something like that.
So their unique value proposition was they actually go on the location they're reporting on.
And then around 2014, 15 is when things started to shift. And they said, well, you know, and then they started relying, presumably, this is my opinion, more on ridiculous clickbait articles.
So this is a really important point. Investigative reporting is like outrageously expensive, like beyond what people can fathom. Because even sending people like flights, hotels, it costs a lot more nowadays. Lawsuits. I mean, we're talking, you're right, hundreds of thousands of dollars to do one story. So if you're a businessman, if you're a venture capitalist and you want to make a profit on this, good luck. Good luck to you.
You know what our budget was for a 3-day shoot? We got a story, boom, breaking. There's civil unrest happening in this country. The president may get ousted. We're sending a crew down, $50,000. It's a bigger story. It's going to take a week or two weekends, $100,000, $200,000. And that was cheap. You've got salaries, camera equipment, travel, you got to have insurance on a $30,000 camera.
Not to mention lawsuits.
Legal. You got people who are going to be detained entering the country. You got people who are going to be pulled out by cops because they're covering this stuff. You've got four people have to go there. You've got security requirements. You've got security briefings. You've got health. If you're going to Egypt, you got to go in for all these different vaccines.